Hello everyone, FunctionX here. Welcome to Feed the Beast Beyond Mods A to Z, where we're going to cover every single mod in the new pack, Feed the Beast Beyond, so that you are an expert and you can show off to all your friends with some really cool builds. So let's get started, guys. The very first mod in the pack, when you sort A to Z, is actually Additions. Now this is going to be a longer video because actually Additions adds a ton of things in the game. So it's created by LPEC. It's pretty much a new mod for Minecraft 1.11. We're using version R98 of the mod. So just a quick disclaimer, things might change in the future and things might not work at all that I explain here. But the cool thing is it has an in-game documentation manual so that if you try something I say and it doesn't work, just check this manual. It should be able to give you good pointers. Now just really quick, look at some of these cool things I built just in a few minutes. This thing here takes power from lava. It feeds it to all these laser thingies, and when you turn it on, they shoot the stone. Come on, guys. Oh, turn them into ores, and then they all breaks the ores, and these little lasers throw it in a chest, and oh no, let's throw it in a chest. Throwing it in a chest over here. Oh, look at all those free ores we're generating from lava. Over here, hey, that's really loud, let's turn it off. Over here, we've got a tree farm, and this tree farm is not your normal tree farm. You wanna know why? Not only does it grab wood and distribute it in this chest right down here wirelessly, it also generates its own power from the leaves that it grows. Sweet! Anyway, guys, there are a ton of things this mod offers, so let's get started. First thing you're going to do is make the manual. The manual has a recipe of canola seeds and a paper. You'll just find canola seeds by breaking canola plants in the world. Once you've got that, you've got access to a ton of things. It adds a bunch of quick tutorials down here just to kind of get you started. There's actually a video out there already that's a little bit older, and that's the reason why I'm kind of making this one is this video is just a little bit out of date. I didn't even mention that when you go to it. But yeah, there's things as a pack. It's got items, it's got RF generation, it's got processing, it's got ore doubling, it's got really cool items such as rings that give you potion effects. There's some really cool stuff in here, guys. It's gonna take a while, so let's get going. All right, guys, so we're gonna start simple and get a little more complicated as we go. You're gonna notice in the world as you get charcoal and coal. Have you ever noticed you want to cook like four things, but you don't want to waste a full charcoal on it? Well, you can get the tiny coal, which gives you eight, or tiny charcoal, which also gives you eight, and they burn one item for each thing. So that's really, it makes a lot efficient. You can also turn your charcoal into a block of charcoal, which is missing from Minecraft. You have block of coal, but no block of charcoal. So that's pretty cool. You've also got this block of enderpearl, which just allows you to store four enderpearls. If for some reason you have way too many enderpearls, you can make a cool little decoration block out of it to store it. You've also got black lotuses. These grow in the ground, and if you break them, and craft them, you can turn them into two black dye. So you don't have to kill any squid if you need black dye. You're also gonna find black quartz ore in the world. FTB Beyond has this disabled, however, so the only way you can get black quartz is taking quartz and coal, crafting it together to get the black quartz. You're also gonna find a few seeds. Oh, I forgot to mention the tiny torch, which is you get two per tiny coal or charcoal, so that's actually really nice, but these don't give very much light. So you might want to use them to mark your way, like when you're caving, if you want to put them on the right wall so you can know which way to get out, but they're not going to really light up a lot of space, but you get a lot more for each charcoal and that kind of thing. So let's look at these seeds. So we've got rice seeds, canola seeds, and flax, and we've also got some fertilizer here. Plant the rice, plant the canola, plant the flax. We can use fertilizer or bone meal to grow these up. And you can see they're very similar style to a lot of other mods where once they're full grown, if you right click on them, you get all the stuff and they actually stay planted, which is really helpful. Now the rice seeds give you obviously rice and seeds, and we can use that later in some food. The canola gives you canola, which you can use for power and some other things. And then the flax gives you string. So pretty cool there with all the things that grow. All right, let's step it up a notch and look into the next things. All right, so the next topic we're gonna look into is the laser or the reconstructor. Now you're gonna first wanna craft one of these atomic reconstructors pretty early on. It's only iron, redstone, iron sticks, and black quartz. So you can get it pretty on. You have to go to the nether, obviously, to get some quartz, but you can make this reconstructor. Now, if you look at the guide for it, go back to page one. It'll give you a whole idea of it needs power. You have to get a, you know, a redstone signal to turn it off, or you can turn it to pulse mode. And then it's going to start doing all of these cool little craftings for you. So let's put it down in the world. It's going to aim this little green light that way, whatever way you you're facing. And you see bottom left, it holds 300,000 RF. I'm just going to use a creative capacitor bank here just to give it power. It will accept power to anything that give it RF. All right, so as soon as we start giving this thing power, it's just going to start shooting off lasers. And that's actually wasting RF because it's not doing anything. So you have two ways to solve that. Either you can put a lever on top, turn the lever on, and it'll turn this guy off. Or if you right-click this with a torch, you can see it's now in pulse mode. And that means it will only fire off when it's given a redstone signal. So now if we put a button here, we'll stick a button on the top. Sure, now we can easily press the button and we've got a pulse whenever we want. Now what do we use this laser for? Well, it's used in some crafting recipes, and the first one are just to get some harder to get vanilla items. So if we put some sand here, we're gonna get soul sand without visiting the nether. That's cool. Put some flesh there, we get leather. Pretty cool. Quartz down is going to give us prismarine, so we don't have to find a temple in the water. And last, mushroom will give us nether wart. So we get some cool items just with vanilla items, but that's really not what the point of this this block is, but it's just some really cool crafting recipes that it has. Now here is what it's really for. Take all your like normal crystals that you find in the world, not really crystals, but I don't know, ores and gems, that kind of thing. Throw those down, and I'm just gonna throw them all at once because it will do all of them. Oops, don't come back to me. And we'll go ahead and shoot them all. And you can see it turned them all into some really cool crystals. We've got the Anori from iron, the Void from coal, Palis from lapis, Diamine from diamond, Emeraldic from emerald, and Redstone from redstone. So it's pretty easy to tell. Now each of these you can craft into armor. You can craft into tools. Where was the tools area? You can make a block out of them, which is cool. I think those blocks look really awesome. But here's the tools. I'm not sure what they're compatible, if they're like iron, you know, or stronger. I think they're about iron, maybe a little bit better. But yeah, you can use these crystals, and those are going to come up a lot more later on. Now, let's go ahead and get rid of those for now. You've also got a few other things that this guy can do. And those in, need lenses. So you've got a bunch of lenses here. Some of these lenses for other things. But you've got a color, a detonation, certain death, killer, disenchanting, miner, and just a generic lens. So you craft this guy first with glass and quartz. That makes your basic lens. And you use that to craft all the other ones. So miner takes a bunch of gems. Disenchanting takes some empowered crystals, which are pretty hard to get, but we can get those later. But then the other ones, you actually have to take a lens and throw them in front of this guy. So let's get this generic lens and throw him down, shoot him with the laser. And you can see that now is now a lens of color. We can cycle through a bunch of these. So shoot him again, he's now a detonation. Shoot him again, he's back to a normal lens. Cool, any ones that we didn't see? How lens of the killer needed a certain death. So some of them, you know, take or upgrades. What was the certain death one? That was a detonation wand. So you know, you can put him back in here and it'll cycle through them and you get the different lenses. The lens of color is interesting. Say that you are having a really hard time getting certain types of glass or anything that can be dyed, like maybe wool. What you want to do is just put those in front of this thing and shoot them, and they'll change colors. Oh, it looks like glass doesn't work. We needed stained glass. That was my bad. All right, so let's put stained glass on there, not glass. And they should cycle through the colors. So you go white to orange. Orange will go to magenta. Magenta to what's this? Light blue. That kind of thing. So they're just going to add one to its metadata. So, you know, could take a while if you wanted like black. Obviously, going white to black takes a while. But that's pretty cool. We can get the different different colors of dyeable items using the lens of color. We can pop that off by just taking an empty hand and grabbing that off there. Let's look at the lens of certain death. Shoot that one off. If it hits a player or a mob, it's going to kill it. Should we put maybe an Enderman there? Oh, he's going to teleport because it's day. Let's get just a normal zombie, whatever. Probably need to, I don't know, just put him there and shoot him. Oh, he moved. Stupid zombie, stop moving. Shoot this one. There you go, he's dead. Are you gonna die? I hope so. Because you're really loud. So that lens of certain death will kill any mobs. It will drop their drops, but not give experience or the extra drops that you get if a player killed them, that kind of thing. If you want that, then you're gonna have to upgrade your lens of the killer to, lens of certain death to lens of the killer. And that one now is going to give you experience and mob drops. So if we spawn another zombie in here and shoot him, you see now he should drop experience, and you know, he could have dropped like a pickaxe or something, whatever he's holding, armor and that kind of things. So that's pretty cool. Then you've got the lens of disenchanting and the miner, and I think we're missing one. What happened to all the lenses? Disenchanting, killer. Detonation, there we go. Oh, it was up there. Okay, detonation is one you gotta be really careful of because it does a very large explosion. Let's make sure there are no plants for this laser to hit for a while. I think this has a range of about 32 blocks, where normally the laser only goes like 8 or 16. But here we go. Hopefully we don't die. Oh, it's gotta have something to hit. Okay, let's put it right about here. And say you wanted to drill a hole through a mountain. Oh my goodness, that is a big explosion. And you'll notice it actually dropped the drops on the ground. So you've got a bunch of dirt and cobble and stuff. So it's actually not a bad way to mine, I guess. I don't know, you probably lose a few drops doing it that way. But yeah, maybe you want to destroy stuff. There's a good way to do it. All right, so next let's take a look at the lens of disenchanting. This is actually a really cool one. You throw something that has an enchantment on the ground and also a book. This can either be the normal book or an already enchanted book. And when you hit these, it's going to take the enchantment off the item and add it to the book. So now I used to have attack 5 on there, sharpness 5. Now it's moved the sharpness 5 over to the book, so it's combined with unbreaking. So that's pretty cool. Maybe you got an enchant that you don't like, you can pull it off. Or you, if you have a really good enchant, you want to, you know, put everything on a single book, you can. You can't pass it from one item to the next. You'd have to take it off onto a book and then use an anvil to put the book, you know, the enchantment on the new item. But that is a really cool little block that I don't think I've seen in any other mod out there. And then the last one, you've kind of seen it over there, but it's a lens of the miner. You need some stone for it to hit. And you need a lot of power. I think it's like 60,000 power in this thing, or it won't do anything. It'll just shoot a laser and do nothing. But if it has 60,000 power in it, you'll shoot it out there, and you look, now we've got poor silver ore. Hooray. All right, so that is all the lenses and all of the things for the Reconstructor. All right, guys, the next topic is one of the coolest things about this mod. It's its method of transporting power and fluid and items around using lasers. Now, the first thing we'll talk about is power. Now, let's pretend we have this base, and we have all our machines, all the stuff. We've got the generator over here, and a bank, a capacitor bank over here, some kind of furnace, and then another energy cell. Different mods, they all take RF, right? Well, what we can do is, let's say this thing's generating power. Let's just give it some blocks of charcoal, because that's part of this mod, and it'll cook those up and generate tons of power. But we want to get the power over there, right? Well, we can just stick one of these energy laser relays on it, which you build like this. Redstone obsidian, a redstone crystal, an advanced coil, which is gold nuggets, more redstone crystal, and a black quartz. So, not the cheapest thing in the world, but it's really powerful. This is the basic one. You put it on top or anything anywhere around it, and it's going to be able to grab power out of there, right? That's not what I meant to do. Now we just go stick one of those on all the things we wanted to receive power as well. And there's no such thing as really as in and out. It's just basically able to share power, kind of create a network. All these blocks or act as if they're connected to each other, sharing power. The basic one can transfer 1,000 RF a tick. So yeah, this generator is nowhere near that. The advanced one is 10,000. It takes some empowered stuff, which we'll learn about later. And then the extreme one is 100,000 RF a tick. But it's not doing anything right now. We need to get this laser wrench. We'll go ahead and shift right click on there. It stores that laser location. As soon as we click here, you can see they're actually joining up. They are now putting power into this guy here. Now let's say that this thing is now done generating, whatever. See, it's transferring 100 RF a tick there. And that's gonna go there. Now, if we put another one of these guys here, which already was one, and hook him up, we don't have to hook him up to here or here. It doesn't really matter. They're all going to be part of one network. So now this guy is drawing power out of the capacitor. It's also drawing power out of the generator, and he should have plenty of power. Yep. Same thing with this guy over here. They're all networked. Now, a couple rules about it. 15 blocks max distance between lasers. There is a tiny percentage of energy loss that increases as you go through the higher versions of the relay. And for any other things, you can refer to the book. But it's a really nice way to transfer power. You don't have to run pipes all over the place, as long as you don't mind looking at this kind of bright red laser all the time. And you could even put this on the back of them. And does it transfer through blocks? That is a question. Yep, no problem going through blocks. So really, you could put it on the black, the back of one of these, like that. Have your wall to your base, and then just transfer, you know, from here to a battery or something over here. So that is really cool. It's like coming out of that one now. The only way to if you hit it with a compass, it'll change it from input to output, or both. So that's one way you can, if you want this only to input or only export, that kind of thing. And the only way to really get rid of it is to break it and then redo it. Okay, so that's energy for us. Now let's talk about items. We can probably just go over here to show you that. In here, I've got a chest full of stone. Now I need some way to get it into this item interface. This is kind of like the magic import block for all of the things to work on. So I could use a hopper to hop into there. I could use like pipes to pipe into there. But it adds another block called the ESD, which is basically a really cool hopper. It's every time you look at this, it picks a new, not every time. Right now it's an extreme stuff distributor, extreme sand digger. It changes. It's pretty cool. But it's a hopper with multiple inputs, multiple outputs. You can say, where do you want the in to come from? I'm coming from the east to that chest. Where do you want the out to come from? I'm going up there. And you can say, I only want to look at slots 100 through 108. And it'll say, okay, you're only going to get these slots down here, and it won't import that. So that is really, really cool control there. And then you can also choose which slot it outputs to when it goes outbound. Really cool. Once it's in the network, then we can just put one of these, the green ones on there, which are the item lasers. And you've got the basic ones, which don't really have any interface at all. You just kind of link them up, and they connect to like that and like that, and there it is. It's connected, and items will come out or go in based on, they'll come in through this block and then it'll be exported out to there just on a generic zero priority. If you get a compass, you can change the priority as the tooltip is showing us so that things will go into chest first. That's just kind of like a generic item moving. You don't have a lot of control. If you want to use it for some kind of like a storage system, you're going to go with the advanced item relay. And one thing you'll notice is the advanced item relays do not connect to the normal. Oh, they do. Okay, something has changed since I watched the tutorial on that. But the advanced ones have an interface. And so you can set them to whitelist items to import and export. Or you can switch it to blacklist. You can say to respect the metadata value, the NBT value, the OR dictionary value, or part of being part of a mod. So you could say, I want everything from forestry to go into this chest or something. So this really, really powerful item storage where you can have this input chest for all your stuff coming out of quarry, all your stuff going into just a basic drop chest. This one guy would say, okay, pull everything out because I blacklisted nothing, and then have advanced item relays here that you say, okay, this is everything from Buildcraft, and then this is a chest for everything from, some other mod. Or you can say, put my wood here, kind of stuff. Whatever you desire, you can do. So let's link those back up. I've set it here to keep my block placers full of stone. So that's why the stone's coming out there and it's just filling all of these up. I can transfer again over 15 block ranges between lasers. So yeah, really cool stuff. The last thing that we have with lasers is the fluid laser. And unfortunately, I can't get these to work in the FTB Beyond pack. You're supposed to attach them to any device that has a liquid in it. So we got a bunch of different tanks here. I've tried with even like drums and Ender's tanks and all that kind of stuff. And when you link them up, you can say flow in which direction you hit it with a compass. And when you say only output of adjacent blocks, it's supposed to actively extract fluid, which it's not doing, and it's not putting it into any block. So not sure if that's a bug in the mod or something in the pack, but these aren't not working in this pack. Okay, next let's cover a few of the blocks that don't take any power at all. They just work. First we have the auto breaker, and all it does, like it says, is it breaks blocks that you put in front of it. Let me get some blocks. That would be helpful if I had some to demonstrate that. But there you go. It breaks as if it was mining it, so stone turns into cobble. There's no silk touch upgrade, which would be really nice. But again, you've got the mode where right now it's going to work all the time. If you had a lever on it, you could turn it off, or you could right click it with a redstone torch and it would be in pulse mode. So whenever it got a redstone signal, it would break. But you could use this in a skyblock for cobble gen, right? With a lava and water source here. And yeah, there you go. So block breaker. Now, also, we have an auto placer. That is just the opposite. You put blocks in there, it's going to place them down. Cool. What happens if we do this? Instant cobble gen! I don't know, there might be some kind of mod where you need to place an item and break it. You know, obviously just use these two blocks. No power, no redstone signal, anything. It would just transfer from one to the next being broken. All right, let's stop that because it's getting annoying with the sound. All right, the next one is very similar. We've got the fluid placer. Let's come over here where we've got some places for the fluid to go. If we go and get a bucket of water, we can put fluid in there and you can see it placed it. There's no, is there an interface? Oh yeah, so it can hold 8 buckets of water. Let's go ahead and fill her up and it will just place it. And you've got the fluid collector over here. Just does the other thing. So it's gonna collect the, place the water and collect it. Pretty cool. So if you wanted to collect like a bunch of lava, you could just put this thing down the world. And I guess it would only collect, yeah, this is more for an infinite, you know, water. If you have an infinite source, that kind of thing. I guess it could be used for other things. You can find some creative way to use it. But fluid placer, fluid collector. Now we've got the automatic precision dropper. Now Minecraft already has a dropper, so why do you need this one? Well, let's just get the Minecraft dropper out to figure out why. First of all, it looks a lot cooler. And if we put some items in here and go ahead and give it some kind of timer, it's going to spit them out, right? Oops, that is not a timer. Didn't I say clock? This is the one I want. There we go. It's going to throw the items out and... Oh, wait. That's not what I wanted the guy to... Oh, wait, what? Come on. It's just throwing them everywhere, right? Throwing a bunch of blocks. It's like 4 blocks away. They're not stacking. They're not going the same place. Pretty maddening, right? So that's pretty cool. Precision dropper, if we put those items in there, you'll see it doesn't take a redstone signal and it drops them right in front of it all in a nice stack. So if you want to drop something in a really, you know, a good place, for instance, to use with this laser, you could put the precision dropper right here and it would drop them right in front of it. Awesome. And no redstone signal, no power required. It would drop them all out. Cool. Now, what do we want to do if we want to actually collect them again once they've been dropped? Well, we get the ranged collector. There it is. And it was somewhere in my inventory. And we just go ahead and put it like right here. So let's put some more blocks in there. You'll see they'll drop out. Collector, are you going to grab anything? Oh, it's set to whitelist. So it would only block, do something if we said, you know, whitelist this. Let's see, we've got a cobble there. Throwing some tires out, throw some stone out, and you can see the stone doesn't even hit the ground. This thing poofs items. It's not like a magnet where it like sucks them into it. It just poofs them as soon as it sees it within its 3-block range. And so again, if now we blacklist, then it's going to start grabbing the timers and the cobblestone instantly. Isn't that amazing? So now you can control what you want to grab. Maybe you only want to grab items and not the stupid tools that zombies drop and, you know, always clutter your inventory. You can now whitelist things. Now, what if you need more than 12 items to whitelist? Well, you can grab a filter and you can put a ton of items in here and then stick the filter itself in the here. So that's cool. Awesome. Love the control that this mod adds. Let's move on to the next thing. We've got the experience solidifier. This is a nice block. Unfortunately, it's not available in FTB Beyond. I'm not sure if there's an issue with it or what, if it's overpowered nature or something, but basically if you stand on top of it, it's gonna suck your experience and out of you. Or if there's like experience balls on the ground from like an XP potion or something, it sucks them up, goes in there, and it creates these little solidified experience balls, which then you can eat to grab experience. So that's all it does. It's really cool, but it's not available in FTB Beyond. All right, so the next item we've got is a fishing net. Now you need to place this on top of the water. Really the only way to do it is to place it on the side of a block. If I just try to click on the water, you see how it goes down in. So if we put it on the side of a block, you can see it hovers over the water, and then you can, don't wanna do that. Put it on the side, there we go. You can, cow, get out of here. Showed him. There we go. So we've created a nice little fishing net. You probably want to create a couple of these because they're not very fast. And then you can go ahead and get either a normal chest and just put that on top, and it'll actually push items up to that. I don't like the way that looks. So probably what I would do is grab one of these range collectors and put that there, put it on blacklist. So it will grab anything that appear here. You're going to be able to get fish. You're going to be able to get enchanted books, anything you would normally get from fishing. If you hate to fish. Pretty cool. All automated. Grab fishing items. Okay. Then what we need to cover next. Oh, greenhouse glass. Let's talk about farming here. Let's get a hoe. Because actually additions makes farming really nice. Let's make a diamond one. We're getting a diamond hoe, of course. A few things I want. I want greenhouse glass. I want some seeds. So maybe we'll start with some canola. And I don't want to do water. I don't like having water in my fields because I fall into it, or I have to put some kind of like trap door on it or something. So instead of water, I'm gonna get worms. Now you normally get worms if you look them up here. Can I search for it? There you go, worms. Worms can be gotten by simply tilling grass with a hoe. So every time we till, we have a chance for a worm to appear. Yeah, is that a worm? I think that was. Cool, so we've now got a worm. Now, if normally this would, tilled land would turn back to dirt, but if we put a little worm here, he's going to keep a 3x3 area not only tilled, but hydrated as well. Look at that little worm work. He's amazing. You might want to put two down because sometimes I've noticed the land doesn't always stay hydrated 100%, but he's just going to travel a little circle path and keep this 3x3 plot tilled and hydrated. All right, so now we can go ahead and plant our canola seeds. And not only is he going to keep it tilled and hydrated, but he's actually going to make it grow a little faster too. Now, if we want it to grow even faster, we can put and close this in a greenhouse. And really, you only need the block right above your crop to have this. But as long as this crop can see the greenhouse glass with nothing in between, and the greenhouse glass can see the sun with nothing in between, you can see it's applying growth ticks, so that one is going to grow a lot faster than the others. Pretty cool. So yeah, I like that greenhouse glass. Really nice block. Okay, let's get rid of some of this stuff that we're done with. All right, next up we've got the automatic feeder, which I just deleted because I'm a doofus. Automatic feeder works like a couple other mods, but we can put a bunch more stuff in it, and also has some nice things. So let's get some cows. This also works for sheep and pigs and chickens. Let's get some wheat, and let's get some kind of fence to hold them in. And I'm gonna make a quick little pen for our cow. All right, put a few cows in here. Now, normally if you used an automatic feeder like this, like Railcraft for instance, you would come back and you would have 1,000 cows or something, you know? This mod is a little bit smarter. It detects how close the cows are together and assumes if they're too close together, they, you don't want to breed anymore. But let's go ahead and break this one and put the automatic feeder down. And you can see it's giving the cows love. Sweet. That will only work if you have wheat in here. So every time this reaches to the top, it's going to push some wheat out to a cow. There you go. Probably made him happy. Didn't really see the hearts. There he goes. He's happy. They're happy. They make a baby. Cool. But again, yes, it's going to detect how many items you have or cows around it. And if you have too many, you know, per acre or whatever yard, per meter, it's going to stop breeding so that you don't get that overload, which is a really cool addition to this block that the other ones do not have. All right. Now, the next thing is if you want to make some fertilizer, which is a replacement for bone meal, we showed that off earlier, you can get one of these composting bins. Now, the composting bin, let's get some recipes out here. Takes biomash. You're going to need a wood casing, which is wood and oak wood. It's pretty easy to make. Hey, go back. So you make one of these composts. The biomash, you take a knife and any four food items. I don't think you're going to use golden apples, but you could use fish, seeds, melons, anything you want. You're going to get biomash. So let's go ahead and grab some of that. You can make the knife too. It's really easy. And you just click them all in here. I guess I put 64 in there. And that is going to convert to fertilizer. And I believe the fertilizer just pops off. Okay, so it's going to take this, and over time, it'll convert it into fertilizer. And then I would just right-click to get the fertilizer out of there. And we use that as bone meal. Cool. All right, so that's that block. Almost done here. The last thing is the storage that's added by Actually Additions, which is really cool because it's so big. Let's say we just have a normal chest, right? Let's put it right here. And we fill it up and we're like, crap, this chest is too full. I really like where it is, but it's not big enough. And I don't have room to add a second, right? Because there's all my machines around here. I can take this crate upgrade and switch it from a chest to a crate by shift right clicking. All right, now it's a crate. Watch how big this thing is. Holy crap, it's four chests or more. I think it's a little bit more than four chests. That is awesome. So we've got the small storage crate, medium and large, and we've got upgrades for all of them. So once we have the small, we can do small to medium. By shift right clicking again, look at that thing. Woo, it's like a diamond chest. It has two tabs. Maybe it's bigger than a diamond chest. And the last one, the large storage crate. Holy crap, this thing has three pages. Amazing. You can store a billion items in there. No, not a billion, but it's a lot. Now, another thing you have is, what if you want to move this? Because it's got so many items, you don't want to break it and have all the items fall on the ground. Well, what you do is you put one of these tokens inside the chest, okay? And then I need to get out of creative mode and break this thing. I can just break it with my feet. You'll notice that I probably should have done that different. I didn't really show it very well. Let's say I have 64 worms in there, and I do not want one of these worms to go on the ground. That would be unsanitary. So I put the token in there, and then I break it. And you'll see the worms did not go on the ground, neither the token. If I put it back down again, the worms are still in there, but the token is lost. So every time you want to move a chest, you just put the token inside it, break it, and put it down, and you'll all the items will stay in there, but you'll have to recraft the token. And it's not too bad. It's planks and iron. Pretty cool. I know Beyond has a chest mover, item, so you really don't need this, but it's a pretty cool thing that they've added. I like the mechanics of it. All right, so that's about all the mod things that don't take power. All right, next up, we should probably talk about how to actually generate RF with Actually Additions. You've got quite a few mods. The first one, or a few ways. The first one's solar. It's not an easy recipe. You need empowered stuff, which we still haven't covered. But solar goes down there. Yay, it's just a block. Chancellor's power between them holds 30,000 RF. I think it generates 40 RF a tick. Am I correct? 8 RF a tick. Sorry, I was way too high. but yeah, there you've got that. You can use your power transfers to connect them and send them off to your different mods. It's really nice to just put them on top of something. That's solar power. You've now got the heat collector, and this takes power from lava, and it does it in not an overpowered way, I don't think, as much as some mods do. You need four sources of lava, connect are all around to it. So with three, it's not generating anything. As soon as you put the fourth down, it starts generating RF, and that is done at 40 RF a tick. But it's, there's a small chance every time it does that that it might eat a lava source, and then it generates nothing. So you've always got to kind of babysit it with lava to make it generate lava again, or to generate power. All right, the next one is kind of a more advanced one. You've got to take a canola press and put some canola seeds or canola in it. I'll just grab some from JEI, it's faster. So the actual canola, not the seeds. And that is going to... needs power, okay. Takes power to make power, guys. Yeah, so we put some power in there. It's going to take the canola and make canola oil. And we can use the canola oil in an oil generator. The canola press is putting in there, and we're making power and then using power. Yeah, apparently. It's using power to power this, which is kind of interesting. But anyway, we don't need this anymore. It's powering itself. It's net positive as long as you keep canola in there. Really cool! But if you don't, if you want to generate more RF a tick, you can take this fermenter here, which also takes RF, so we might as well like put it here or something. And if we put the canola oil in there, do we have any canola oil buckets? Sure. The canola oil will then use RF a tick and convert to canola. It's a regular oil. It actually doesn't look like this one takes RF. It just takes regular canola oil, converts it to regular oil. And that, my friends, can also be used in an oil generator to generate 100 RF a tick. So there's really no reason to put your canola oil directly in an oil generator. Almost always put it in the fermenter since it's free and you get a lot more RF a tick out of it. Okay, recipe on that one, is it that bad? No. piece of cake to craft. So yeah, do that method is a really easy way. We next got the leaf eater generator. This one, you just put it near trees and it starts eating the leaves for you. And a lot of people in the FTB on forums are saying, why do you have fast leaf decay? And I think this is one of the reasons why is leaves are actually useful. If you don't like leaves staying around and put one of these down, you get RF for deleting leaves. Isn't that cool? And as far as amount of power, it is 300 per leaf broken. You can see it breaks about one every second, so I don't know. It's not a ton of RF a tick, but it's free, right? Especially if you use it this way, where I grow trees, cut them down, suck the leaves for power, and use that power to grow the trees and cut them down again. Yeah, so that is that all our methods of power generation? Oh, nope, we've got the bioreactor. This one exists in a few other mods, but it's very similar, where if you just place one item in there, it generates 4F a tick. If we place a couple more, looks like wheat doesn't go in there, seeds do, beef does. You can see it now generates 100 RF a tick for putting 5 in there. So yeah, if you can generate a lot of different types of plants and items, 100 RF a tick. So I'm going to say it actually additions power generation is a little overpowered for the Beyond pack. It's not going to be that difficult to get, you know, thousands of RF a tick, really, pretty early on. There's no, you don't really need diamonds at all. What's the crafting recipe on this? It's iron. It's just iron, guys, as long as you have iron. Are these empowered? Hold on. Were those empowered? Oh, they were. Okay, well, we might need to go to empowerment. But let's show, now that we've got a tons of power, let's show the blocks that actually use that power. All right, guys, now we've got tons of RF coming in, so let's actually look at blocks that can use it. We have the farmer. Now, this one is going to farm for us in a range. I think it's 7x7. Let's turn it facing this way and give it some power. So easy in this mod. Yeah, now it's got power. You'll see it'll till it. We probably want to put some worms on there. Oops. To keep it fertilized, and I mean keep it wet. But yeah, it's going to till the land, keep and then grow stuff there. So we want to put seeds in the left slot. It'll get wheat in the outside. They're not going to carrots, potatoes, anything you want to farm in here. So yeah, let's just stop it. It'll auto-harvest, auto-plant, all that kind of stuff. It's really nice little block there. We've got a crusher and a furnace. Let's get the furnace first. Here it is. Standard little furnace. Wait, it's not a standard furnace. It's got two slots, guys. He's got to make his better than just any other old powered furnace. Nice. What can we cook up? Let's get some ore, maybe. Some gold ore. That's what we're doing. Half in there. Could craft some iron at the same time. Sweet. Double furnace. Love it. We've then got the crusher. We can put that down. And that's going to crush our ores. This is basic ore doubling, which pretty much every tech mod has these days. It kind of casts too, where people don't want to use it. It's loud, it crushes, you get the two ores, and a chance at a third, you know, the bonus output. Same thing as all the other mods that do this. You've then got the double crusher, if I can find it. Look at that guy, he's got two. Ooh, exciting. So we can crush two things at once. We give it power. And there it goes. So, double crusher into a double furnace. All right, moving right along, we've got the Energizer and the Enervator. Pretty cool. But you can see one's down, one's up. What does that mean? Well, put power on them. One's an input, one's an output. Makes sense, right? Connect. There we go. Okay. Yeah, so Enervator charges. Oh man, I can't remember the difference. No, an Energizer charges things. So it could be items that you're wearing. Let's get like a jetpack. Do we have any jetpacks in here that take power? That's you. Any of you RF generator? There we go. Here's a jetpack. So if we have this on our body, bring it in here, plop it in there, it'll charge it. And then we can plop it back up on our person. We also, maybe if we have some kind of like battery that takes RF, Tech Reborn. Here, let's use the actual editions batteries. Could put those in there. They would store power. A million RF and a tiny little battery. If you then moved it back over to here, you could push the power out of that battery into this innovator. Pretty cool. I think it's sucking it back up as soon as it gets it, though. But that's okay. So that's the Enervator and Exerciser. No, Energizer. The Energizer Bunny. That's how you remember it. Then you've got the Item Repairer. Now, that is pretty nice. Let's get... we don't really have a way to show that. But if you have an item that's damaged, it will repair it at the cost of RF, which is sweet. Always love repairing stuff. I hate crafting something and it breaks on me. So... craft an awesome pickaxe, throw it in here, it'll repair it for you. Then you've got the long range breaker. Now this one, where are we gonna show this off? Let's put it right here. Oops, facing this way. But you can see it could face up, down, left, or right. I don't want you, go away, jetpack. Once we give it power, again, you could do a redstone torch to change how it activates, but right now it's always gonna be active, and bam. It breaks eight block. So this block breaks eight blocks in front of it, and whichever way you aim it. And it's not going to use RF unless it actually detects blocks there. So I've used it over here in this mining contraption to mine eight things of ore at once. No silk touch available to upgrade. Again, it would be nice if the auto breaker and the long range breaker had silk touch upgrade ability. Maybe that'll add in the pack in the future. Who knows? Then if you want even more mining, let's do the vertical digger. Put that right there. And you can see it says mining at Y equals 64. Well, that's, we're at 65 right now. So we're going to go ahead and give this thing power. And you can see it's starting to mine. In a huge, in a 5x, it looks like a 5x5. Oh, this could make a mess. You can see it's... we're not giving enough power to actually do a lot, but it's going to start at the top, mine down 5x5. Right now it's mining everything. You can change it to say only mine ores, and now you can see it's going to go, it's at Y63. You're going to go down to Y62. There it goes. So it's going down really fast now and only going to zap stuff when there is an actual ore. That is really cool. It won't make a huge hole in your world. It'll make little pocks, you know, in the caves. I love that about it, that you can tell it to only mine ores. So again, 5x4 radius, set it to only mine ores, and it's going to be a lot nicer. Cool. Did I hear a creeper? No. Okay. Then let's look at the lava factory controller. Remember, we're going to have to keep putting lava in here because it's going to keep eating it. Well, if we put one of these down on the ground, it'll generate lava, but only if there is iron casings around it. So do it like that. You're going to have to give it RF. That's kind of tricky with the way we've done it, but let's do it like that. And hook it right there. And now it should generate RF, right? I'm not sure how much it takes. Let's look it up. 150,000 RF to make one bucket of lava. But this lava will generate more than 150,000 RF over its lifetime, so it's a net positive. All right, so let's take a look at the player interface. We've got some power here, just creative tank, and I can put the player interface down. It's bound to me by the fact that I put it down, okay? And it's connected to my interface. So that means all the power in here is now transferred in here, can actually charge items in my inventory. So let's get battery. Put it there, starts charging it. Pretty sweet, let's get a jetpack. Starts charging that too. So it has a range of 32 blocks. There are things that you can add to that. So by default, the range is like 32 blocks, which is pretty nice. You can just put it in your base and anytime you come home, it'll charge stuff. But you can even increase that by putting these phantom boosters on top. So you can put up to 3 stacked on top of each other. And this thing's gonna boost crazily. So a huge range where I could get to charge like way out here. All right, so that's that thing. But this also works with items. So let's get like a chest of something. Let's just get a storage crate. Small storage crate. I love how they call it small. Let's just get an item conduit real quick. Use another mods to show off. That's fine. So we're going to extract here, insert here. And let's just put like tons of ore here. They're going to be extracted. And look, they're coming back to my inventory. What's happening? Anything that is input into this interface will go in your inventory. Pretty cool. Now, it's not very smart. It doesn't detect how much you have or that kind of thing, keep you stocked. But it'll, it's just going to go in your inventory. It's really cool. One thing you can do with this, if you want to mess with people, if you get this player probe and you're on a server, you can probe a player by right-clicking on them, or maybe a shift right-click, and then clicking on this, and it'll actually bind this to somebody else, to another player, and you could fill their inventory with some kind of weird stuff. I don't know. But yeah, anytime they die, or, which I don't like, shift, it disables the player interface. So that's okay. But yeah, you could use that to kind of mess with people. Or to fill your inventory with really cool stuff. Okay, is this thing still going? What kind of ores we got in here? Oh, look at that. Some copper, some iron, some lead, and some coal. Cool. All right, so the shock absorber is something that prevents from explosions. So I put some TNT down, trigger it, and this thing explodes. Look, no damage to nothing. Sweet. So if you're worried about creepers or somebody blowing up your base, you could put a bunch of these down and they could not explode your base no matter what they did to try. This finally made fertilizer. Empty hand maybe. There we go, fertilizer. Yep, that's that. Now we've got the fireworks box. And this is kind of just a silly item. It really doesn't do much that's cool, but you put it there and every once in a while it's going to watch fireworks randomly. So you could put again a lever on there, change it to pulse mode, that kind of thing. But yeah, it's just going to launch fireworks. Okay. The item display case we're going to skip for a second, but that one is going to hold items and kind of do them even though you're not holding them. Just think of that. We're going to learn about the items in a minute. So that's all of the blocks. Let's move into the items. I know this is getting long, but just bear with me or skip ahead to whatever specifically you want to see. So actually, Distance has a ton of really cool items. We'll start with the ones that don't take any power source. You have the Traveler's Sack and the Void Sack. The traveler's sack is going to pick items up off the ground. So let's just get a bunch here, throw them down. All right, so by setting something on a whitelist and turning this auto insert on, it'll pick up items and automatically put them in the bag as long as we're not holding it. If we're holding it, it doesn't work for some reason. So let's hold our manual, scoot over this, and we'll see that the stone went in there instead of in our inventory. Just try it one more time. Cool. So that's a nice way to click up items. This works with the item filter as well, so you could click tons of items and they would go in the traveler's sack. Another cool thing is if you have an inventory, you can shift right click and it will put everything in the sack into the inventory. So that's pretty cool. Void sack, you need to whitelist things and it's going to void whatever it picks up. So maybe you're mining and you hate cobble, or maybe you hate granite for some reason. So we're gonna go say whitelist gravel and throw that on the ground. What's this one? There we go. And walk along here. It's gone. Voided it. So that's pretty cool. A nice way when you're mining to avoid stuff that you don't want to pick up. You've got the leaf blower and the advanced leaf blower. The leaf blower itself gets rid of grass near you. So that's pretty cool. The advanced leaf blower gets rid of grass and leaves. You can then take, if you have a full set of tools, you don't want to take up 5 slots in your hotbar, craft them all together and you get the AIOT or all in one thing. And that will do all of the things. So it digs, it hoes if you right click, it'll dig stone as well as if it was a pickaxe. I'm in creative, so obviously. But yeah, so that's pretty cool. It can save you hotbar slots. You've then got the rings. Now you've got all of the different rings here. For each potion effect. And if you hold them in your hand, you'll get that bonus. So I've got speed right now. I got haste here. So I can mine a lot faster, that kind of thing. And I can get strength. Oh yeah, I'm super strong. Different things. Regen, jump boost, fire resist, water breathing, night vision. Anyway. And invisibility. Woo! Okay, cool. So those are the basic rings. If you don't want to have to hold them in your hand, get the advanced version of the rings. These can be anywhere, and they give not only the version 2 of it, but yeah, they can be anywhere in your inventory. They're not easy to craft, though, guys. They take ender stars, which take nether stars, and dragon's breath. So if you want to make this, you have to kill the nether and the dragon. Or at least gone to the end to get face the dragon. But once you get that, I mean, then you can just have a full set of these in your inventory and always have all the potions. Then you've got the wings of the bat. Now this thing takes one of those ender stars again, so you're gonna have to kill the wither and the dragon. So a lot of diamonds and then bat's wings. If you see bats in caves, kill them because these are rare drops. But you need 6 of them to make the back wings. If you hold those in your hand, you are creative flying. Let's see if it works. There we go. So do I need, oh, I don't even need to be in my hotbar. Yep. They just need to be in inventory somewhere and you will have creative flight. So that is kind of overpowered, but it is required to kill the nether and the wither and the dragon first. So I guess if you can do that, you're strong enough to have creative flight. Awesome. And then we've got the power, the spawner changer. So you come across some kind of spawner and it's spawning pigs. Why would you want that? You need to get this spawner changer and first go click on some mob in the world. There we go, I captured him in there. You can see I've got an entity skeleton. And now I can click on there, and now this is a skeleton spawner. So go get an Enderman, bring it back, it'll spawn Enderman, that kind of thing. Remember all the vanilla rules of when mobs spawn apply. Yeah, scenario, it's just gonna change what it spawns. All right, there are a few other items that you can get that it talks about in the book. There's a ton of food that you can make out of different items. It's pretty cool just to, you know, a little more variety. Nothing really interesting in there other than just variety. We talked about the player probe, and we've got jams. Now, jams give you 2 potion effects. Each jam kind of has a different potion effect, but you can only get them from villager trading. So that's the only way you can get it. There is a jam guy in the village. He looks like that. All right, so the first one item that we want to show is the drill. Now, there's different drills, different drill heads. Here's like the main drill. It's diamond with some core and whatever, but you can kind of dye it to have different heads. It doesn't do anything other than change the color. So you can dye it whatever you want to look like. I've got a nice little white one here, and it just drills. Let's turn off creative so I can actually see how it works. Just a digger. Nothing really exciting about that, except we can shift right click and put upgrades in it. So we've got drill speed 1. A little faster. Let's add drill speed 2. Now drill speed 2 doesn't work by itself as far as I know. You can see we're not getting the benefit, but we have to have drill speed 1 and 2 in there to get the full benefit of it. Now it's a lot faster. And same thing, if we put 1, 2, and 3 in there, this thing is just going to be instant with this. How is it on stone? Pretty fast. Yeah, it's pretty fast with stone too. So if you get the 1, 2, and 3, those recipes are some iron, sugar, and redstone for that one. Iron, sugar, and cake for number 2. And now we've got empowered diamonds and iron with that one. Okay, we need to talk about empowerment, guys. It's it's getting there. The other upgrades you can have, we've got a silk touch augment, so that just makes it silk touch. Fortune 2, which really gives fortune 3, but you have to have both. So I can't have silk touch and speed 3, but I could have fortune and speed 3. Fortune 3, speed 3. And then I've got mining augment. We do that. Watch it now. Let's go back into normal. Whoa! Mine's a 3x3. Pretty cool. And then last, we've got the mining augment 2. Again, you need to have both in there for it to work. If I just put the 5 in there, it's just 1x1. But if I put the 3 and the 5 together, I get out now a 5x5 break. Pretty cool. So you kind of have, there's only 5 slots. You do I want the speed or do I want the breaking? Do I want the silk touch? You're going to have to change back and forth. But luckily, you know, like right now you're like, okay, I really just want silk touch. You can switch it out and then use the silk touch. Okay, now I want to, you know, do my 5x5 again. Finally, this block placing augment. You're supposed to say, pick it up and right click on a spot in your hotbar. And then you can add that into your drill and it will allow you to right click with your drill to place blocks. I cannot get it to work. So either I'm doing it wrong or it's broken right now. Maybe there's a better way to do it. Okay, so the item filler is an item that you can use to fill in holes. We've got this ugly hole we just put here. So let's go ahead and shift right click on the stone, and that says selected stone. We have to have stone in our inventory and we need to look at the first corner. So that's right there, and let's click on that and then draw where we want it to fill to. So let's draw all the way over to here. Pretty cool. And it filled, and it did a whole cube. I don't know how I selected down there apparently, but yeah, so that filled it with stone. It used it from our inventory. Just a quick way to fill in a thing, or you could use it to make walls. The teleport staff takes RF and it just teleports you wherever you're looking. As long as you hit an item, it's probably be helpful if I'm creative so I don't die. So yeah, if I'm looking at that block, teleport me there. Look at that tree. can I get out of here now? Maybe, yeah, right there. I can't just teleport straight up in the air. It's not a way to fly. You have to actually looking at a block. But if you want to just teleport over a long distance and there's no block to look at, you can aim up 5 degrees and it will let you fly kind of through the air without looking at a block. But if you aim too high, it doesn't work. Now we've got some extra rings. These were rings that actually take power because they do a little more cool stuff. All right, so whenever the ring of growth is in your hand, it will cause growth ticks to any nearby crops. So run a walk over here, and it grew that for us. Pretty cool. The ring of magnetizing you don't have to hold. It just has to be somewhere in your inventory. It will suck items to you. Maybe. There it goes. So it looks like it about maybe a 4 or 5 block range for the ring of magnetism. And then we've got the ring of liquid banning. When that's in your hand, be careful because it starts getting rid of all everything around there. So I just lost all my lava because I used it while I was in my base. So be really careful with that block. Another little nifty little item, just if you want to like set up a room for Accolade Editions, you might want to make a cool banner. Well, there's a few recipes that you can use now with a banner. With the book, and make a white banner with the book on it. Other things that work with that banner are the Phantom Collector, which we haven't really talked about, the Leaf Blower, the regular one, and the Drill, the white one. So you can make some cool banners. I'm gonna let you guys go through the rest of this stuff. There's lamps, there are spawner shards, so if you break a spawner, you can recraft it again. Ball of fur, a bowl of water, since if you don't want to use a bucket of water. Lush caves are disabled in this mod pack. Another little silly item that you can make in this mod is the smiley cloud. Take some wool and a solidified experience, so I guess you can't make it in this pack because you can't get that solidified experience. That's a bummer. But you can name it. So I can name him like Care-a-lot, and now he's Care-a-lot the smiley cloud. If you give him a special name like Etho, he'll hold a little redstone. There's a few other Easter eggs in there, and he gives you little hearts that he loves you. All right, guys, if you stayed through this long, you get rewarded with the empowerment. It's very similar to Thaumcraft. We take an item and make it better by doing some cool ritual to it. We're going to first take the empowerer, and it doesn't need power. It just stays there. It looks pretty cool. Then you need the display stands, and they need to be 2 blocks away. If we look at the manual here, it'll show us a picture of it. So 2-block gap in between there. And we'll go ahead and put the display stands. So 1, 2 right there. 1, 2, oops. And last but not least, one right there. All right, these all need RF, so we're gonna need to, probably the easiest way is to dig out under and put these on the bottom, maybe. And well, there's gonna be one right there. All right, now that we have those, we can power them all up. Dum, bam, 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 bam. Might as well make a diamond. No. You can't do it. If they're already part of the same network, you can't connect them. Let's put a creative relay then right down here just for kicks. No, probably want to put one of those on there. All right, so then all have power now, so they should be good to go. Clean this place up. And now we can empower stuff. Well, a few of those recipes. The first one, let's just talk about this diamondite crystal. Go ahead and put that in the middle. And we need to put, a light blue, clay, clay, and clay. Look at that. Laser. And now it's an empowered diamondite crystal. So they all have recipes here. If you go into actually additions, and look at all the empowered stuff. You can see there's the void crystal. You need flint, charcoal, ink sac, and stone. So it's not that much. The material is actually pretty easy to get any of these. Like nether brick, redstone bricks, yeah. I don't think I've seen one that's really challenging to make. You can actually do an entire block at the same time, so it's probably better, more efficient. You probably need more power, but you know, don't have to waste all these items again. And you make the empowered stuff, and that's how these are useful for crafting a lot of the more advanced items. But yeah, that's the empowerer. And one thing we forgot to talk about is this display stand on its own. Well, if it has power and you put a ring in it, let's put the, ring of speed in here. That ring will now apply to anyone in the area. So now I should now constantly have a speed buff. If I'm not in creative. But so that's pretty cool. And you can also do it with like the Ring of Growth. Very similar to the Bostani rings and stuff. But so yeah, I should put the Ring of Growth on there. Get it off of the shift right click. That would should make anything in the area grow really fast. I don't think it'll reach over there. But yeah, so that the display stand is pretty cool. It takes a little bit of power and an item. I think you put the leaf blower in there to prevent grass from growing. You could also put a leaf blower. Let's do it. We do this fast. Put this. You go away. Put the leaf blower on you. advanced. Give it some power. And you guys said fast leaf decay wasn't in the mod pack. Oh, that thing is so loud. Wow, okay. I don't know anyone that could survive with that on full time, but it works, it's there. So yeah, if you're playing Feed the Beast Beyond, you definitely need to look into this mod. If you're not, put this into your pack or play it single, just by itself. It really does, it's standalone. It adds so much really cool stuff. Guys, come back next time. We're going to move to the next mod in the list as we sort them alphabetically. I might skip over some of the smaller mods, and we'll definitely skip over the mods that are just library mods that don't do anything, but help other mods work. So yeah, come back next time and we'll see which mod we explore. Hope you guys like this one. Go out and download Feed the Beast Beyond. Catch you guys later. This has been FunChunX. Bye.